Hi, this is Giovanni Segura, and you're on Leave It in the Ring Radio. Who do you got?
This is Rashid Warren here with Leave It in the Ring Radio. Okay. Who do you got?
This is Tim Bradley, and you're on LeaveItInTheRing.com.
Absolutely, you certainly can. 347-215-7598 here on Leaving the Ring Radio, or you could tweet us at Leaving the Ring, all capital letters, LIITBOXING. And don't forget to download the app. Let's talk boxing here this weekend. We got some upcoming fights. Everybody's excited about Mexican style. Gennady Golovkin getting back in the ring with Marcos Antonio Rubio. You're going to see Nonito Donaire. He's getting in there with Walters. That's a very interesting. Actually, I'm more excited about the Donaire and Walters fight than I am about the Gennady and Rubio fight.
This fight, I mean, are you excited about Triple G versus Rubio? It's kind of like, you know, the guy, well, it's going to be a good fight. I know it's completely one-sided, but, you know, it's going to be a good fight. That's not really what a good fight is to me. It's all one-sided. It should be, you know, equal. And like you, I like the Donaire versus Walters fight. I think it's exciting. Walters has kind of come on, you know, in recent fights and has shown himself to be quality, and this is his big step up. And Donaire, I mean, Steve tweeted it the other day. We've been talking about it on the show for a couple of weeks. I don't think his desire is there anymore. It hasn't been for a while. It hasn't been.
I've been saying that for how long? I think I've been saying that for 2 years straight that, you know, he's not a fighter anymore. You know, I think it's fair to say that he's a guy that really just soaked in whatever fame that he got out of beating Victor Chinian, and then it died out, and then he got that recognition again when he knocked out Fernando Montiel. But I think he was in spurts, and if he's trying to gain that spurt back, it might be a little too late. And you know what? Steve had a chance. I had a chance to watch that interview that Steve did for his network. And he said, you know, the motivation is not the same, and that he sees Walters hungry, but he doesn't want his son to see him lose or anything like that. But to me, it was actually like an opening that you kind of leave open just in case you do lose.
I don't understand why it keeps. Yeah, it's been, you know, since the. Well, I kind of do, but I don't want to be rude, you know, and talk about somebody's family. But I really think it's. Like you said, he's become more of a family man, and his mind is on other things. And I don't get the sense that it's like it's giving him pause as opposed to like fire, you know. So I'm not. Yeah, I wonder in this fight. I don't think of him as a 26. I haven't heard great things from camp, so I don't know. You know, we'll see how things go. But I'm picking Walters by late stoppage. I think he's going to be too physical, too strong. I mean, maybe Nonito, you know, doesn't get stopped, but if he does get stopped, it's going to be on the stool.
I don't know. You know, I said this when it got announced. Remember, I said that I see Walters stopping him. He's just sharp. He's strong. Nonito's punches have gotten wide. He's really forgotten how to become a counterpuncher. He's struggled in his last couple of fights. He's a guy that just has an engine with no steering wheel. He just runs on fuel, and he's going to do his best off of those fuels. Where Walters is a complete package. He's a complete sports car. He's got the wheels. He's got the driver in the driver's seat, and he knows how to navigate his punches and where he wants to go when he decides to move. I like everything that he brings to the table, where Nonito, to me, is now just a demolition car. He's just going to go for the wreckage and hopefully come out a lot cleaner than he's looked in the past. I just don't see him taking it. I just don't see him doing anything different or special unless he really has evaluated his career and kind of looked at, hey, you know what? I got to go back to old regimens. But that being said, we already know every camp has never been good for him. Why? It's not the people that are behind him. It's definitely he's the problem. He needs to wake up and realize either you're going to be a fighter or you're going to be a celebrity. You can't play boxing.
You kind of nailed it when you were talking about, you know, with him with the photography and all that. And he
right.
He's just kind of Nonito Donaire superstar. And he's a really nice guy. I mean, he's like, you know, genuine person, I think.
Let's patch in. Let's go with area code 714, you're on live right now and leaving the ring. What's on your mind?
Hey, guys, it's Lenny the Fightsmith. I wanted to quickly touch on the Golovkin thing that you guys were just talking about.
Go ahead.
I know it's a mismatch. Golovkin's going to win. I think it went up to 101 to odds in Golovkin's favor now. But right. I kind of look at boxing less of a sport now and more of just it's really a series of exhibitions. And this is just next in line. This is a big thing. Like Gabe just said, it's a happening. And Golovkin's kind of turned into a happening, and I'm going to be there. I mean, unless I can sell my front row seats for like over $1,000 each, which is possible. I mean, I'm going to be there, and I'm excited about it. It's going to be a packed house. There's going to be celebrities there. I think right before I tuned into you guys, Kellerman was talking about it on ESPN Radio. I mean, full on selling it on ESPN Radio. And this is a middleweight fight with a guy from Kazakhstan that most people can't even properly pronounce.
You know, you're right. I think, too.
You're right. You know, it is exciting. Sorry, Dave. I didn't mean to cut you in.
No, I was just going to say, listen, I mean, don't get me wrong. In order to create a star, you got to have some sacrificial lambs out there. And that's obviously what they're doing. But at the same time, I think, you know, if you see a spade, you got to call it what it is. It's a spade, you know? And that's exactly what we're getting here. Exhibitions, absolutely. This is nothing new in boxing. This has happened for years and years, you know? This is a tactic way that promoters drag and pull in more fight fans that are not hardcore fans, that are not going to follow up and look at a guy's record until they're kind of sucked in into the hype. Is he the real deal? Yeah, I think his power's there. I like his footwork. He still needs head movement, but he also needs that opponent that's really going to get me to go, you know what? This guy's the factor. He's the it factor. He's the next, you know, big thing. They're building him up to be the next big thing. And, of course, in boxing, we do need those stars. He has that crossover appeal. Why not? I'm not mad at it. But I'm also not going to be one going like, well, yeah, this is great, this is fantastic, blah, blah, blah. Because at the same time, it can't be hypocritical. When we call one mismatch, you got to call the other one.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely think that the Walters-Donaire card is the fight to watch. I mean, that's
right.
The boxing
the quality.
Fight right there.
Yeah, big time, you know. All right, brother, I'm going to put you back on hold, man. Thanks for calling in.
Thanks, guys.
Area code 860, you're on live right now, leaving the ring. What's on your mind, brother?
Hey, what's up, guys? How you doing? CT,
what's up, brother?
What's up, man?
Hey, what's up? Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to that doubleheader this weekend. I also have Walters winning. I think Donaire has experience, advantage, and athletic ability, but at the same time, like you guys said, his confidence had definitely gone down. And I think Walters' confidence, ability, and he seems like a hungrier fighter at the moment, and I see that playing into this fight. I have Walters possibly stopping Donaire on the stool. I think I don't think Donaire's confidence is up as it was in the past. I think that Rubio and Donaire fight did something to him mentally. We see it throughout the fights that he had after that, and I think it's going to play into this fight. I'm picking Walters by a late round stoppage around 10th or 11th round.
on the stool too, huh?
Yeah, on the stool.
Oh, man.
With the Triple G and Rubio fight, I think it's kind of interesting to me because we've seen Rubio dealt with a similar type of style with Lemieux, but at the same time, Lemieux is the type of fight who gasses out late and stuff like that, and Triple G's on a whole other level, you know. I think Rubio's style, as far as him being the macho Mexican aggressive style and the way he wants to fight, Triple G is going to play against him in this fight. I can see Triple G stopping him like around the fourth or fifth round.
Fight fans, you want to call in 347-215-7598. Dispatch to some more fight fans here on Leaving the Ring Radio. Well, no, listen, hold on. Somebody on Twitter put, nothing for something. Gigi and Rubio is less of a mismatch than the Klitschko and Briggs fight you all are calling for. Hey, listen, I didn't say it wasn't a mismatch. What did I just say right now? I said a little while ago, if it's a mismatch, you got to call it what it is. You know, if Madonna and Floyd Mayweather was a mismatch, this has got to be a mismatch as well. Is Klitschko and the Briggs a match or mismatch? Yeah, it probably is. It probably should be. It's going to be looked at that because you got a fresher heavyweight that's been dominant for how long, and then you got Briggs who was not successful against the older brother who is not as good as the younger brother. You're absolutely right. It is a mismatch. That's what we're calling it. Let's go. Area code 916. You're on live right now in Leaving the Ring. What's on your mind?
Now, I was hearing y'all about the GGG Rubio fight and along with Donaire and Walters. And first off, with Donaire and Walters, if Walters wants, Walters, he's bad, man. He's a bad dude. You're comparing his knockout victory to Donaire's current, his most recent victory over right. Darchinian, both of them. And Walters, man, he worked that boy, man. I think he just put Darchinian into retirement. But if, look, Walters, he's big. He's physical. He's a big 126er. I think he's big enough to be a 140er right now. And Donaire, he don't have the eye of the tiger anymore. Ever since that Regal fight, Regal took his heart. He made Donaire had that look. Once he got that first down with Regal, he wanted to quit. And the other day, right? the homie Steve Kim, he interviewed Donaire and he asked him if he has the same passion for boxing like he did in 2010. And even right. Steve Kim was surprised. He said he was surprised because Donaire said he wasn't. For Donaire, look, either one of these cats is going to get knocked out. And the way I see it, it's going to be Donaire, and it's going to be early. It's going to be quick. If anything, it's the fourth round tops, because like I said, man, Walters is a bad motherfucker, all right? I didn't discover him till the Darchinian fight. I was like, damn, son. And Donaire, he's going to have to be the old Donaire, the Donaire that took stardom when he defeated Vic Darchinian when he barely became world champion. That's the way he's going to beat Walters. He needs to get the eye of the tiger. Like you guys mentioned it before a few calls earlier, when the open training for this week leading up to the fight, like you said, Walters, he has the eye of the tiger. Like I'm here. His eyes basically say, I'm here to fuck shit up. And Donaire, he has that look like you said, like I've been here, I've done that. But in his most recent fights, he would always have the eye of the tiger, like I'm Donaire, you know what I'm saying? He was in the top 10 pound for pound, and then ever since he lost to Rigo, he got lost. He disappeared.
So you're going for the fourth round, huh? Early stoppage, huh?
Yeah, yeah. You know, I'm going to be nice to Donaire, so I'm going to say fifth round, the latest. All right?
Fifth round. Well, man, you got CT, who just called in earlier, said they're going to stop him in the stool. You say the fifth round. Okay, brother. Hey, man, thanks for calling in. Appreciate it.
All right. I just want to let you know I was a first-time caller and appreciate it, and I'm going to call again soon.
All right, man. Yeah, thanks for calling in. All right there. Fight fans, you want to call in? 347-215-7598. Let's talk boxing here on Leaving the Ring. Talking Nonito Donaire, Anna Walters, and Gennady Golovkin versus Marcos Antonio Rubio. Mexican style. Let's patch in another fight fan here on Leaving the Ring. Let's go. We're going to go down the line, so we got a lot of calls today. Let's go. Area code 408. You're on live right now on Leaving the Ring. What's on your mind?
Hey, what's going on, fellas? This is Gabriel from Gilroy. I was going to say about the Triple G that you were saying about the mismatch. I don't blame him so much because who has he turned down, you know, him and his team so far in terms of who's on the table? I don't think other people had options, you know what I mean? They ducked him. I don't think he has those options. And I think anybody outside of Ward, Ward gives him trouble. If you look at that Stevens fight, he has trouble with speed, hand speed. I mean, he shelled up. When Stevens let his hands go, he went high guard, and he didn't transition from defense to offense well. He just kind of took him, backed him up a little bit. I think Ward will give him a hard time. He'll either clinch or turn him and, you know, score points, that kind of thing, ugly. Anyway,
I think, let's be fair, Ward will give anybody trouble going up north or south. I don't think we're mad about it being a mismatch. You know, I think it's going to be a great exhibition, like the last caller had called it. It's an exhibition. It's going to be a great exhibition. But to sit there and go like, oh, man, this is going to be a phenomenal fight, to kind of hype it up that we're getting equal parties here that are on the same level, I think that's a little too much. We need to call exactly what it is. It's going to be a really good mismatch where there's going to be an entertainment value behind it. You know, you're going to get explosion. You're going to see a knockout. There's a guarantee there. You know what I'm saying? But the anticipation of seeing Rubio pulling the upset, it's very, very slim. It's just really, really slim. But it's not Gennady's fault. I agree with you with that. It's not Gennady's fault because he's been calling and asking for everybody to step into the ring with them. It's just the other guys don't want to, you know, they don't want to tangle with the guy. But go ahead, bro. What's the last thing you want to talk about?
Right. So the other thing, I mean, I agree with you. It's going to be any chances to watch him fight an exciting fight, I'm down. But
right.
The other thing with Nonito, Jun, I mean, I like the guy. I think he's done, man. Like you guys have been saying, mentally, Guillermo, Willie, Rigo, he took him, man. He took his soul, you know. Rigo's a soul snatcher. I mean, he's El Chacal for a reason, you know what I mean? He knocks off stage, and you never come back. And when a grown man on a pound-for-pound list gets taken like that, you question your manhood. You question a lot of things that – if you're not hard to the core, I'm sorry, you ain't going to last in that business. I'll tell you that. And I think all that got brought out, and this fight's going to be tough for him. If he goes into deep waters, good luck, man. I wish him the best, but I don't see it, man.
This fight is staring into the abyss. You know, it's going to be a long night. I really feel that. It's going to be a really, really long night. Actually, not that as long as scheduled, though. I expect 10 after the 10th, they call it quits.
Man, what's your pick for Saturday night?
I'm picking Triple G and Walters, man. I think it's going decision with Walters. I mean, it's going to take a lot. I mean, Walters got some power. I think June will stay in there, but, man, it's going to be rough. I can't pick a round.
All right, fight fans, you want to call in 347-215-7598. Let's go area code 931, you're on live right now in Leaving Ring. What's on your mind?
Oh, Eduardo. Just moved from Knoxville to Fort Lauderdale, back home. So happy. Hey, yo, I can't wait for Triple G to crucify this guy. You know, I read this this meme on Twitter earlier today. He's going to knock the last bit of pigment that Rubio has. That was pretty funny. Kind of ruthless, but it is pretty funny.
I guess. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I don't mean to be like that guy at the party that is just it's kind of kicking him. I don't know.
Right?
It's kind of just mean, you know? It's kind of just mean.
Darn cloud strikes. There we go. Well, Eduardo, I'm going to put you back on hold, brother, because you just brought down the party yesterday when you called in. All right,
be easy, guys.
All
are you
right,
serious,
brother.
Bro? Are you serious?
Are you serious?
Know,
all right, man. Let's go down.
You know, like, I can't make fun of some dude's skin condition. Like, you know, I don't know.
I didn't see it, so I couldn't. I don't know what you guys are really talking about. I'm just kind of, you know, going with the flow with it. Fight fans, you want to call in 347-215-7598. What do I know? I'm just a boxing fan here. We're going to get into our Everybody Hates Monday rant really quick. Rob Riller, are you out there, brother? I'm pretty sure that's your number.
Yo, Walter sucks. I'm joking with stuff. Yo. No, you know, last time I picked somebody that went against an old guy. Not an old guy exactly, but in age, but in fighting uh-huh. years, Sean Porter, you know, I picked him up. I was really hype off the Malachi win, and that's what I'm thinking about going with the Walters fight right now. I don't want to do that, and Nonito's still a very skilled fighter, whether his heart's in it or not, and we don't know much about Walters. We know that he can walk through old men, but we don't know if he can deal with somebody that can punch from different angles. You know, Nonito still has power. He still has lightning fast speed.
Lightning
and
fast?
Walters,
has he watched his last couple fights? How do you know he's not the old man in this fight? I mean, Nonito's
I don't want to completely dish him out. You know, I just don't want to completely rule Nonito out. You know, I still will take his skills and what he's capable of. You know, we know what he's still capable of. I don't know what Walters is capable of. You know, that's my thing. I don't really know. And
that's
I don't
a fair
want
statement.
To be a
yeah.
Sean Porter thing. So, I'm not saying Walters is overhyped. I'm just saying we're going to find out Saturday, you know, depending on what happens. If he blows Nonito out, yeah, you know, I guess Nonito was a little bit, you know, but I don't want it to either. I don't want to take away from his victory either. You know, I don't want it to be a thing where, oh, well, he beat Nonito easy. You know, Nonito was washed up or he didn't care about it. You know, I don't want it to be that. I still think Nonito still has skill. I still think his skill can be taken into consideration. And Walters is going to get a good test. Gennady Golovkin, on the other hand, should knock Rubio out pretty easily. unless he gets caught with some craziness, like, you know, but which is capable of happening. We saw him getting hit in the Stevenson fight. But I agree with Walters.
I mean, look, we don't know if he could take Nunez. Nunez still has punch behind his when he throws it. It's a bigger division for him, though. We haven't really seen that devastating power that he has. But I'm still curious what happens when he does get touched by Nunez, who does carry speed and does have semi-power. I'll tell you what would be impressive is Walter stopping Nonito Donaire, because Nonito hasn't been stopped. He was beaten, really. Right. He was beaten pretty bad by Rigondeaux. Yeah, but he was never close in my eyes of being stopped. He was just completely schooled. Now, Walters is a different beast. He's a different type of fighter. I don't think, you know, he'll ever even come close to what Rigondeaux brings to the table. But he's going to be an engaging guy. And that always leaves openings. That always leaves, you know, a possibility for a guy like Nonito to open up and catch him on the way in. So, to me, there's still a lot of value to that fight. But I think it is fair to say that Nonito, not taking away the skill level from him, I don't think he's a fighter anymore by heart.
Saturday night, October 18th, at the Stub Hub Center in Carson, California. Gennady Golovkin versus Marco Antonio Rubio. Middleweights 12 rounds for Golovkin's WBA title. Nonito Donaire versus Nicholas Walters. Featherweights 12 rounds for Donaire's WBA title. Edwin Rodriguez returns versus Isaiah Agostama. Light heavyweights 10 rounds. He's an Al Haymon fighter, so he's probably making more than anybody else on the card. at the 2300 Arena in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, NBC Sports, Steve Cunningham versus Natu Vicinia, heavyweights, 10 rounds. Edgar Cherry Bomb versus Jerry Belmontes, super featherweights in action, 10 rounds. Tyron Brunson versus DeCarlo Perez, middleweights in action for 8 rounds. And that is your weekend fight schedule. Should be fun stuff. Triple G fight should be fun. You know, I mean, it's going to be one-sided. We know what's going to happen. I got Triple G in 4. I got Walters in 10. We'll see. You know, I mean, Donaire is a very controversial fighter, and that some people believe he's that dude that lived off of, that, you know, fought older guys or kind of, you know, the right matchups. And he's a top-ranked guy. Of course he has good matchups. But I'm really curious to see, you know, what Walters brings to the table. Is he the real deal, or is Nonito going to outslick him? You know, I don't know. I tend to think the back end of the fight is going to be tough on Nonito.
Yeah, you know what? In a lot of ways, the fight is interesting. You know, I mean, like I said, the fighting spirit isn't really there for Nonito, but the cruise control is. Walters, all he's got to do is be Walters and not get overzealous and do something stupid where he gets caught coming in, you know, because Donaire still got speed. This is not a tear down physical fighter. Physically, he's still got the goods, but mentally, I don't think his mind is there. Hopefully, we have some great fights here. Hey, thanks for everybody calling in. Don't forget to download the app every Monday. You got the next round here on the Leaving Ring Network. It's at 5 o'clock with yours truly, Gabriel Montoya, and Mr. Steve Kim, the K9. Don't forget, Tuesday, you got our all-Spanish boxing radio show on the mobile app only. It's not on the Blog Talk, but it's on the mobile app. So you can catch that there every Tuesday, Boxeo Tijuana Radio. And every Thursday, well, you got Leaving the Ring here. You can always call in 347-215-7598. You can always tweet us at Leaving the Ring, all capital letters, LIITRBOXING. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram and on our Facebook fan page. Or you can email us at leavingtheRing@gmail.com. There you go, man. Tail end of our show. Thank you, everybody, to tune in, to listen up. Thanks for everybody that calls in every week. Continue calling in. Let's continue talking boxing. You know, the more we talk about the situations in the sport, the more we bring on more people on board that go, hey, there's something here. We need to talk about it. We need to attack it. We need to, you know, kind of go for it and, you know, stand by our sport, because nobody obviously is going to stand by our sport except for us. We can already see it. It's been happening for how long? You know, these guys just taking advantage of us, poor little blue-collar fight fans, you know, taking our money. And you know, sad, they're not even taking our money. We're just willing to give it away. Isn't that sad? That's sad, man. They're just willing, like, yeah, man, hey, you know, here, take this. Hey, take my car. Take the keys of my house. Do whatever you want. It's okay. I'm only going to bitch and moan about it on Twitter, and then after that, I ain't going to do anything. But here on Leaving the Ring, you have a chance to say something, and it's going to be, you know, I don't know if it's going to be heard, but at least you have a chance to say it, right? Anyways, don't drink and drive because you will spill your beer. Enjoy your weekend with your family and friends, and we will talk to you guys next week on Leaving the Ring Radio. Good night, everybody. Mr. Gabriel Montoya, I'll talk to you later. Adios, amigos.